should consume 131.1 litres of beer per year. This is the second highest per capita consumption after the Czech Republic, which is shockingly high. Didn't know that. I know they're big for their Guinness, but that's about it. So, yeah, there's quite a few places in Ireland that I'd like to see. Lots of places, actually, which I haven't written them down, but yeah, it's probably more than just a long weekend away. It'd have to be a full-on holiday, I think. I just got nobody to travel with, which is a shame, but you know. So some of my favourite Irish actors and comedians to follow after. So I've got Robert Sheehan, who was in Misfits, and the film Mortal Instruments, City of Bones. Brilliant film. I just find him really funny. He's got an amazing sense of humour. So if you watch like the behind the scenes in films or interviews with him, he's really funny. Like, really funny. Aidan Turner, who is in, of course, Baldock, which is a massive hit. And just, I was also in the Hobbit films as Killy, one of the, he wasn't a Hobbit, was it? I think he was a dwarf. But he's, yeah, very, very, very good looking. Chris O'Dowd, who is in the IT Crowd and Bridesmaids. He's hilarious, and as a comedian as well, he's very, very funny. Sorry, Therese, I'm talking really fast. I'll try and slow the pace down a little bit for you. Andrew Scott, who was in Sherlock as Jim Moriarty, evil person, but my God, as an actor, he can do some amazing things with his voice, like really good things, like. Because he's evil in Sherlock, he does, just makes his voice go really high. It's incredible, really. Another very good series if you ever get the opportunity to watch it. Colin O'Donoghue, who's in Hook in Once Upon a Time. I've never really seen him in anything else, I don't think. But he's very good. He's very good looking as well. But he's not Irish in the show. He's Irish in real life, but in the show he's, British accent. And this is so interesting, but Michael Gambon, I didn't know that he was Irish. If you don't know who Michael Gambon is, he was Dumbledore in Harry Potter, and I am a huge fan of Harry Potter, so that's why he's on the list. And also then I've got Evanna Lynch, who was Luna Lovegood. She's an amazing actress actually as well. Just the way that she portrays Luna is incredible. Like, she really carried that character off very, very well. So I've now got some comedians for you. Aisling B, who, she's done quite a lot of stand-up. I watched her recently on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown. She was funny on that. And Travel Man with Richard Ayoade. I can't remember which country that they went to, but they went somewhere in Europe for 48 hours. She was really funny in that. She's got quite a witty sense of humour, a little bit of a dry sense of humour, but very witty, very good. I've also then got Ed Byrne. He's funny. And of course Dara O'Brien. And Ed and Dara did a couple of years ago now, I think, a road trip. Ah, gosh, I think it was like through America down through to Mexico. Just the two of them, and that was really good, because the two of their sense of humours really, really worked together very well. It was good fun. David Doherty, who looks just like Chris O'Dowd, like the two of them. It's weird. It's kind of ironic that they're both Irish. They're both comedians, and yet they look like they get confused by people quite often, which is really funny. But yeah, David Doherty, I saw him on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown last night, because it was a rerun from a few years ago, but yeah, he was was really funny on that. So I've got finally I've got Graham Norton, does the Graham Norton show. He's really entertaining. He's got an amazing way with people and the way that they like actors and actresses when obviously when they go on his show and everything. But yeah, he's funny, he's very good. I've also got Spike Milligan on my list, which I've got his book here, of A Children's Treasury of Milligan, Classic Stories and Poems. So I'll read some of these out for you in a little while. I just wanted to read the last couple of points that I had, which were a couple of ASM artists that are Irish. So you've got Melanie Murphy. She's very good. She's got a really gentle voice, very lovely. And Irish Whisperess, I think that's how you pronounce it. Yes, so both of those are very good, and I like watching them occasionally. So, yeah, like I said, I'll put the links for you in the description to their channels. Against my reasoning, don't fail to add the appropriate seasoning. In short, some of these make absolutely no sense whatsoever, but it's like, it's just how his brain, I mean, they're not all his, some of them are sort of other poets that he's put in here, but he always, you know, puts who it was that wrote that one, but most of them are his. So we've got, there was a young soldier called Edser. There was a young soldier called Edser. When wanted, was always in bed, sir. One morning at one, they fired the gun, and Edser in bed, sir, was dead, sir. That's quite morbid for Children's Treasury. You took questions. Let me just find some others for you. Children small, 1415. Once saw a bee go in a hive. They'd never seen a bee before, so waited there to see some more. And sure enough, along there came a dozen bees, and all the fussed about. Then one by one they all flew out. Said four, those bees are silly things, but how I wish I had their wings. That's quite sweet. Today I saw a little worm wriggling on his belly. Perhaps he'd like to come inside and see what's on the deli. Hello, Jolly Guardsman, in your scarlet coat. It reaches from below your tongue to halfway up your throat. Tell me, Jolly Guardsman, when you're off parade, what kind of clothes do you put on? Civvies, I'm afraid. I don't know what that word is. Bit of a random one. Let's try a different. Which is a little annoying, actually, I'm not going to lie, but that's just the quirkiness of Mr. Milligan. Okay, this is quite a long one, but we'll give it a go. The ABC. 'Twas midnight in the schoolroom, and every desk was shut, when suddenly from the alphabet was heard a loud tut-tut. Said A to B, I don't like C, his manners are lack, for all I ever see of C is a semicircular back. I disagree, said D to B, I've never found C so. From where I stand, he seems to be an uncompleted O. C was vexed, I'm much perplexed, you criticise my shape. I'm made like that to help spell cat and cow and coo and cape. He's right, said E, said F, whoopee, said G, ip, ip, hooray. You're dropping me, word H to G, don't do it please, I pray. Out of my way, LL said to gay, I'll make poor I look ill. To stop this stunt, J stood in front, and presto, ill was Jill. You know, and V, that W is twice the age of me. From as a Roman, V is five, I'm half as young as he. X and Y yawned sleepily, look at the time, they said. Let's all get off to Betty Pye's. They did then, said. There's an alternative last verse, apparently. So, X and Y yawned sleepily, look at the time, they said. They all jumped into Betty Pye's, and the last one in was said. That's quite good, actually. Let's. I like the illustrations with it as well. They're quite funny. There's a massive long story here as well. Hans Mann sucks from a chicken's laundry.
This is a funny.
rhymes. Okay. I don't know this one. Eggs will rhyme with legs, but eggs aren't hairy or fat. You can boil an egg for breakfast, but legs wouldn't stand for that. Dog will rhyme with log, but a log isn't man's best friend. And you can't throw a dog on the fire. If you did, he'd be hard to mend. Cat will rhyme with hat, but that, my friend, is all. A hat won't drink a bowl of milk, and you can't hang your cat on in the hole. Snake will rhyme with lake, but only the snake eggs, otherwise they are both identical, for neither of them has legs. Gosh, some of them are very strange. It's very hot here still. It's a bit overcast today, so it's a bit darker in here. I hope it's not too dark, but life is just so humid. Let's two funny men. I know a man who's upside down, and when he goes to bed, his head's not on the pillow, no, his feet are there instead. I know a man who's back to front, the strangest man I've seen. He can't tell where he's going, but he knows where he's been. That's by Castle Crag, Sydney, in February of 1980. For you.